Why does the organization cause people to work so hard? Like, I see that they may work 14 hours per day at little or no pay and virtually no sleep. And how can you... In fact, well, these hearings are demanding on us and on you. How can you continue to work this way 7 days a week? And why must you work so hard to be a Scientologist?
Well, as I want to point out, is that I left in 1959, and I don't know much about that.
You said you had the blown, you devised the blown
in the beginning, yes. Right, and
brought them
back
and forced them to work.
Set the tone and the standard for the long, drawn-out, heavy amounts of times that people had to put in it. Also, the pay was incredibly low, like during the 50s. Sometimes, even then, people in the organization were only getting $5 or $7 or $10 a week. And they were living sometimes a dozen to a room. All the money went to Dad, and it was kept as tight as he could financially about paying things out. One of the problems too, because if you're not receiving much money and you're putting a great deal of, see, we had a goal, you know, clear the planet, and everybody was being very dedicated about it. But another problem we had too there, of course, was health. Now, remember that psychiatry and medicine was one of our major enemies and opponents. And of course, since Scientology, Dianetics, could cure and alleviate anything and everything and had the answer to all of man's problems, one did not go to doctors. Of course, one didn't have enough money to anyway, but one did not go to doctors, and people's health suffered a great deal. And there's quite a number of people that I know personally that suffered a great deal because of that.
All right, one other question before I turn it over to my colleagues here. Do you think the people who are in Clearwater, who parade up and down the street, do you think that they are a danger to themselves or to the people of Clearwater?
Are they a danger to themselves?
Or to the people of Clearwater?
Both.
Would you like to explain?
It's not really easy to explain, but first of all, they really don't know what they're doing. The average people coming in the door in Scientology, until they get to the very, very top, they don't really realize that they buy step by step. They start believing this all of the various falsehoods, like for instance L. Ron Hubbard's past and etc. They just don't know what they're doing. And
Do you feel if your father should die of natural causes, what effect would that have on the faithful?
I think it would. I really have no way of predicting, but I think that there's a couple of quotes that my father used to say all the time that really scare me to death. He at one time also was talking about really taking on the world, and I remember 1958, an example which scared me to death and started myself thinking.
He wanted me to devise a plan to try to steal an H-bomb.
Your father wanted you to steal an H-bomb?
Hmm?
Your father wanted you to steal an H-bomb?
Yeah, he wanted me to.
From whom?
Anybody and everybody. We got to...
I never got into it because I said, oh, no, thank you. And sort of things went click in my head, and I said, I have two children. I don't want to get involved in that. And that was in late 1958.
Did he want you to steal the parts or the whole bomb?
He only wanted the whole package. But the As an example, one of the things he said to me was that, he said to me many, many times, he says, don't call it murder, call it suicide. And there's another quote, I connotate loyalty as the highest ethic. That means follow me. That means total dedication, total loyalty to me, L. Ron Hubbard. And that's the one thing that he put before any and all, everything.
So and because of...
So anyway, that would lead me to believe, and just knowing as much as I know about it, that...
I will not pursue that anymore at this point. One other question. Is it, do you think that the organization wants to control our economic system?
Yes.
Thank you.